In DV360, advertisers represent real-life businesses that run advertising campaigns. If you're an agency, you'll build advertisers for your clients. If you're a direct marketer, the advertisers will represent your brands. If you're a publisher, this level will represent your brands, your advertising brands, your agency clients, or any combination based on your structure. In this video, we're going to create a DV360 advertiser that is linked to a CM360 advertiser. Before you can create a new linked advertiser, you must have admin access to your DV360 partner account, the highest level of your DV360 hierarchy. You'll also need to create a new DV360 association within your CM360 advertiser's floodlight configuration, so let's start there. To share an advertiser's floodlight configuration from CM360 to DV360, first, grab your DV360 partner ID. You can do this one of two ways. In your DV360 URL, you'll find your partner ID after the /p/. FYI, the advertiser ID is also listed in your URL after the /a/. The other option is to expand the Partner Settings tab in DV360, click the Basic Details subtab, and scroll down until you see your partner ID. After you've located your partner ID, copy it. Next, log into CM360 and navigate to your advertiser. Click the Floodlight tab in the left panel, then the Configuration subtab, and expand the Display and Video 360 Association section on this page. Click the New Association button. Read and authorize the Information Sharing Notice, then enter the Display and Video partner ID you want to link to. In my case, that's the one I just copied. The association status in CM360 will read, Authorized, not linked to Display and Video 360. Once the configuration is added to an advertiser in DV360, this status will change to Linked. Now click Save. Back in DV360, let's create a new advertiser. Open the Advertisers tab of your DV360 partner. Click the Create Advertiser button and enter a name for your advertiser. Since you're linking this advertiser to an advertiser in CM360, this name should be aligned with your advertiser name in CM360. Then provide a valid website. This is the base URL of your advertiser's website, which is used mainly for the system audit process to tell the system what kind of ads it can expect. Since Honeycomb Hills isn't a real business, I'll use Adswerve's website. But make sure that you enter a website owned by your business and not a page on a publisher site, like a YouTube channel, Facebook page, or App Store page. Next, select the advertiser's currency. Note that this cannot be updated once you save the advertiser. You can skip the billing profiles block. All of your billing will come to you through Adswerve. Now let's set our ad server and attribution settings. This is another area that cannot be edited after it's saved. In the Ad Server and Attribution section, click the pencil icon. Then select your ad server type. This is where you can set up the link with your CM360 advertiser to enable all of your creatives to port over automatically. Your ad server will default to Campaign Manager 360 and third-party ad servers, so we'll leave that as is. The rest of the settings in this section relate to your selected ad server. Note that we're moving forward in this video with CM360 as our ad server. But if you do not use CM360 as your ad server or do not wish to link this particular advertiser, check out the video on how to create an unlinked advertiser. For attribution settings, pick the applicable floodlight group shared from your advertiser in Campaign Manager 360. If you don't see the ID you're looking for, it hasn't been shared with your DV360 partner yet. Now enter your Campaign Manager 360 site settings. The Site ID section is important because it tells the system where to port your elements to. If you don't have an existing Campaign Manager 360 site to sync with DV360, select Automatically Create a Linked Campaign Manager 360 Site for Me. You'll then need to traffic creatives and tracking ads to this new site for syncing. If you already have a Campaign Manager 360 site to sync, select Add My Own Campaign Manager 360 Sites and enter the site IDs. Only placements, creatives, and tracking ads within these sites will sync to DV360. After you link a site in both platforms, anything trafficked to that site in CM360 will be pushed to DV360 from that point forward. If you're trafficking something you don't want in DV360, don't use this site in CM360. The placements in this site will be available as creatives in DV360. There are a few more options on this page, but we recommend leaving those on their default selections. If you have questions about any of these settings for your specific use case, reach out to your Adswerve rep. Once you've finished, click Create. The new advertiser will now appear in the list of advertisers in your DV360 partner. Remember, after you create a new DV360 advertiser that's linked to a CM360 advertiser, it can take up to 24 hours for placements, creatives, and tracking ads to port over to DV360.